Hello, viewers, and welcome to our first installment of eNews, and our first segment is World News. Over to you, Adrian.
My name is Adrian.
My name is Devi.
And here we're reporting live from eNews. A meteor struck across the Ural Mountains in Russia last week, injuring more than 400 people, many hurt by broken glass and causing explosions. Fragments of the meteor fell in a thinly populated area of the Chelyabinsk region, the Russian Emergency Ministry said in a statement. Authorities in Chelyabinsk said the blast, which has been heard at an altitude of 10,000 meters, suggesting it occurred when a meteor or meteors entered the Earth's atmosphere. Residents in Chelyabinsk heard the explosion at about 9:20 a.m. local, saw a bright light and felt a shockwave, according to Reuters. Take a look.
Man killed in rare fatal shark attack. A shark possibly 14 feet long killed a swimmer near a popular New Zealand beach on Wednesday, then disappeared after police attempting to save the man fired gunshots at the enormous predator. Police Inspector Sean Routine said in a statement that the swimmer, who was in his 40s, was about 200 meters offshore when the shark attacked. He said police went out in an inflatable surf life-saving boat and shot at the shark, which they estimate was 12 to 14 feet long. Police recovered the body of the swimmer, whose name was not yet immediately released because his relatives are yet to be notified. Girl who performed for Obama shot dead in Chicago. A 15-year-old girl who performed at President Barack Obama's inauguration last week was shot dead in Chicago by a gunman who opened fire in a group of kids hanging out in a park. Hadia Pendleton, described by a relative of Walking Angel, was sheltering from the rain under a canopy with about 10 or 12 other teenagers Tuesday when the gunman leaped over a fence, opened fire, and then jumped into a getaway car at 2:30 p.m. Mala Riva Steenkamp was shot dead at the home of Olympian Oscar Pistorius in Pretoria, South Africa, an official said. The details are the latest to emerge in the shooting death that has roiled the nation and left South Africans asking what went terribly wrong inside the upscale Pretoria home of a man nicknamed Blade Runner for his lightning-fast prosthetic legs. Authorities have released little about a possible motive in the Valentine's Day shooting, while local media have reported that Pistorius had mistaken his girlfriend for an intruder. Police have charged Pistorius with murder. South African prosecutors have said they intend to upgrade the charge to premeditated murder, but have not released further details.
The second presidential of Barack Obama was held in Washington, D.C. on Monday, January 21, 2013. A week of festivities, including the presidential swearing-in ceremony, inaugural address, inaugural parade, and numerous inaugural balls and galas honoring the elected President of the United States. The 20th Amendment states of the President must take the oath of office on January 20th. Since the 20th fell on Sunday, a pirate swearing-in ceremony was held on the date on the following day. The official theme for the 2013 inauguration was Faith in America's Future, commemorating the United States' perseverance and unity, marking the 150th anniversary of the Emancipation Proclamation and placement of the Statue of Freedom atop of the Capitol Dome in 1863. Watch Obama's speech now.
Vice President Biden, Mr. Chief Justice, members of the United States Congress, distinguished guests, and fellow citizens. Each time we gather to inaugurate a president, we bear witness to the enduring strength of our Constitution. We affirm the promise of our democracy. We recall that what binds this nation together is not the colors of our skin, or the tenets of our faith, or the origins of our names. What makes us exceptional, what makes us American, is our allegiance to an idea articulated in a declaration made more than two centuries ago. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
Hello, eNews viewers. I'm here at the stadium. I'm your host, Jerome, and I'm here with Azia Mahusin, the first female Olympian to come from Brunei. She participated in the London Olympics in the previous year, and she's here with us to answer a few questions. Okay, let's start with the basics. Tell us a little bit about yourself, and how old are you, and where do you study?
Well, I'm 19 years old, coming 20 this 18 March, and study at Micronet College, which is at Jerudong, and I'm a full-time athlete too.
What has inspired you to become a full-time athlete and participate in these games?
Well, actually, at first nobody inspired me. I mean, I just love running, and I mean, just passionate about running. You know, like every time I run, I feel like all this freedom and something like that. And track and field in Brunei is it's like a rare sport in Brunei. So I want to show and inspire Brunei, well, especially for people out there, to, you know, to join track and field. And I want to show the world that Brunei also have potential athletes, especially female, of course.
How does it feel like being the first female Olympian from Brunei?
It's such an honor, like, it's a huge honor, and of course it's a dream come true. I mean, I didn't expect to be participating in the Olympics like this early, you know, but even though it's under the concept of universality, I'm just happy to see the flag of Brunei being hoisted in London.
And you also
Yeah, and it's great, you know, like, it's like being ambassador for Brunei, like, it's an awesome feeling. I mean, even though I didn't win anything in the Olympic, but, represent Brunei, the Olympic is already a gold medal for me.
Okay. What age did you start joining these kind of events?
I joined when I was 14 years old, and I became serious when I was... Yeah, 14 years old. Yeah.
Okay. So, I also heard you were a national hockey player. So, have you joined any hockey competitions?
Yeah, I was a national hockey player before when I was 13 years old. And at that time, I started to run also, but at that time, I mean, I still confused which sport I want to choose between track and field and hockey. So, I mean, hockey is not really my thing, so I stopped hockey and joined track and field.
Aside from those sports, what else do you play?
I think hockey and running. Mostly running.
Okay. I'm pretty sure a lot of people now know your name, both locally and internationally. How do you cope up with the fame?
Well, I didn't expect this thing to happen, you know, but for me, it's such it's a great honor though. I mean, especially people know that I'm from Brunei, especially like people know Brunei already, like last time they didn't know that, they thought that Brunei don't have those potential athletes, but now like all the world know that Brunei also have a potential athlete, so I'm really, really happy, and hopefully we'll like gain more athletes in the future.
And finally, do you have any word of advice for those aspiring athletes out there?
Oh yeah, for those youth out there. I mean, if you want to do something that you like to do, just try and do it. Go out there, just try your best. Be patient, you know. Maybe next time you will can achieve what you will get. But just don't give up. That's it.
So that's all the time we have for today. And thank you, Ms. Mazia, for taking the time to come with us and do our little interview. I'm your, once again, I'm your host, Jerome, and signing out. Bye.
Hello, eNews viewers. I'm Patricia Nicole reporting to you about our school events. Our first school event for this year, 2013. Our school events are Free Day and Induction Day.
This passing bring our school great blessings and good luck for this year, of course, the coming year. Koshi Bacha.
To complete the great blessings, to be showered in our school and our SMS's family, let us welcome, once again, the Chinese Culture Club to bring us their much-awaited Lion Dance performance! Let us give them a walking round of applause!
Thank you.
We're here strolling by the pool in this luxurious hotel, where tourists usually tan and rejuvenate.
That you'll need are 130 grams of chocolate, 130 grams of butter, 200 grams of sugar, 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 3 eggs, 1 and a quarter teaspoon of salt, and 95 grams of flour.
Before you start, preheat the oven about 180 degrees, and once it's done, it only takes like 15 minutes. This is the mixture of melted butter and melted chocolate. After you melt them, put the sugar in. Then you just stir it in. Keep mixing it until it's
extract.
mix the eggs into the mixture, you add flour. The baking tray and baking sheet, and then just grease the melted butter on the baking sheet. After that, you pour the mixture into the Now after you're done with pouring the mixture into the baking tray, put this into the oven. Hit it about 30 to 35 minutes. 180 degrees. It's been 30 minutes since the brownies was put in the oven, and now we're gonna take it out.
Basically.